Like to call the Parish Council meeting for Wednesday, December 14th, 2016, to order. Official time is 6:05. Would y'all please stand for the prayer? Mr. Martell, would you please send a prayer, please?
Yes, sir. Lord, we are meeting today to conduct matters of business. Guide our hearts and our minds in the spirit of fairness. Right thought and speech, impart your supreme wisdom upon our activities so that our affairs may reach successful conclusion. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Mr. Brown, would you lead us in the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Madam Clerk, would you please do the roll call?
Tommy Collins.
Here.
Jay Davis.
Here.
Tommy Landry.
Here.
Lloyd Brown.
Here.
Warren Gottesman.
Here.
Tommy Broussard.
Here.
Paul Landry.
Here.
Ricky Gonsalas.
Here.
Joel Dugas.
Here.
Gina Olivier.
Here.
Brian Napier.
Here.
Robert Francis.
Here.
Marty Trahan.
Here.
Chad Mochman.
Here.
We do have a quorum. We'll proceed. Approval of minutes, regular meeting, October 26, 2016, published November 30th.
Move.
Move by Mr. Brown.
Second.
Second by Mr. Olivier. Roll call. Regular meeting of November 9th, 2016, published December 7th, 2016. Need a motion?
Move.
Move by Mr. Landry.
Second.
Second by Tommy Landry. Roll call. Those motions carry. Persons to address the council. Persons applying for consideration of appointments to Iberia Parish Boards and Commissions to address the council to announce their interest in said positions. Anyone in the audience is applying for a board commission, please step up to the podium, state your name for the record.
My name is Heidi Parker Martin. I want to thank you for the opportunity to put my name out there for the appointment to the Tourist Commission. I believe that I'm uniquely qualified for this position. And so I'd like to give you, the ones that don't know me, a little bit of a background. I'm a longtime resident of Iberia Parish, married with two stepkids, and I'm one of the lucky ones because I really like them. I'm active in the community. I'm very proud to be a Berry Queen and have been for the last several years. I'm on the board of directors of Iberia Habitat for Humanity, and I'm a recent graduate of Leadership Iberia, of which I'm also proud. But I said I'm uniquely qualified. The reason is such, I've worked in a number of aspects of tourism. For example, I've worked as the marketing manager for a venue, for a marketing director for an attraction. I was the marketing director of the Lafayette Natural History Museum Planetarium and Nature Station. I've also worked as marketing director for a venue, the Frem F. Bustani Convention Center and the Hyman Performing Arts Center. I've worked on a number of events. For example, I worked the first 7 years of Festival International de Louisiane, helping to plan that event. It has turned into such a phenomenal event. I've also worked on Festival Acadien on the board of directors for a number of years, planning the museum's portion of that festival. One of the other things that I've done, though, was I was the visitor marketing manager for the Lafayette Convention and Visitors Commission. As such, I was in charge of the tourist center that's located in the median in Lafayette, oversaw all of the volunteers, oversaw all of the distribution of materials. I also traveled extensively across the United States trying to market Lafayette in particular, but Acadiana by extension, to tour operators to get them to come to our area. So I'm very familiar with what our area has to offer. And tourism is one of those things that's really, really important. I pulled a statistic. For every dollar that is spent in this area by the state, $5.86 is returned to the coffers. And that's the kind of return on investment that we could all use around here. And instead of talking about seeding some of our wonderful events to other communities around us, like the Sugarcane Festival, I think it's important that we really start working to put out the welcome sign for Iberia Parish, and I'd like to volunteer my time and effort in doing that as part of the Tourist Commission. So I thank you, and if anybody has any questions for me, I'm more than welcome.
Any questions for Ms. Parker? Thank you, Heidi.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Gail Garcia. I am currently honored to be serving on the Tourist Commission, and I would like to exit. I'd be reappointed to the position. It has been a great pleasure to see things happen in Iberia Parish, and I hope that I can help to continue that trend. If you do not know me, I've been around for many, many years, serving the community, but over 30 years for sure. But I am a former journalist, so I know all about publicity and marketing and getting things out to the state. So I've been very successful and have actually won a great number of grants for my public relations campaigns, including a national award. I am a volunteer at a local museum, which I do programming for. We have received excellent reviews for our programming. We're becoming well known in our community. And in 1 year, our attendance doubled because of programming. So I hope that you will consider me. I have also been, if you have been in the library world, I have been both on the St. Mary Parish Library as public relations and publicity director for them as far as programming, and Iberia Parish Library also, I did public relations and programming for them for many years. So I hope to be considered for reappointment, and thank you so much for your time.
If there's any questions for Ms. Garcia? Thank you, Ms. Garcia.
Thank you.
Anyone else that needs to address the council, apply for boards of commission? Hearing none, we'll move along. Item two, representatives of the Louisiana Sugarcane Festival Fair Association to address the council about recent developments regarding the 2017 site. Please step up to the podium, state your name for the record.
My name is Ronald Gonsolin, and I am president of the Festival Association. I've been before this council before, different members though, on behalf of the Levy District. I was chairman of the Levy District for a few years, and I find myself addressing you all on a completely different set of circumstances. But nevertheless, it's important to me, but it should be equally as important to all of you sitting in this room. So I thank you for the opportunity. And also, before I begin speaking, there are some others here with me from the Festival Association, and they're right here behind me. Would y'all please stand? And also we have Fran with, she's defensive of the festival as well, Fran Thibodeau. So thank you all. And I do appreciate the opportunity on behalf of all of us to tell you a little bit. And I'm gonna give you five reasons why I think New Iberia and Iberia Parish is important to all of you. The festival is one of those, but I will go through those five. And I live in a little community called Charlotte, just west of here. Not many of you know where it's at. It's got a little white church right alongside the road. Looks like it's misplaced. Looks like it belongs in Nebraska, Oklahoma, someplace like that, but nevertheless, it's there. I live very, very near to that. And just right across the street from that is where the Goo Goo Brothers grew up. Anybody know about Goo Goo Viator? Big Goo Goo, Little Goo Goo? Well, if you are a member of the sports club, or I guess if you are maybe fooling with alcohol and something like that, bootlegging, then you know those boys. But that's in the heyday of the Watneys. Sheriff G. Jerry Watney. Go a little further down the road is Jefferson Island. If you haven't been there, shame on you, because Jefferson Island is worth every effort of you getting there, particularly if you want to have lunch. It's a beautiful place. Avery Island is equally as important to all of you. It is wonderful to visit. I mean, it is really a nice place to go. And if you want to have lunch, go there as well. And then you go down to the Shadows. Shadows is by far one of the greatest assets we have in this community. It really, really is. And for those of you that have not driven down Main Street, then right after this meeting, I challenge all of you, travel down Main Street and just stay in awe of what it looks like. It's lit up, it is wonderful. And you really need to do that. The festival is part of this. The Louisiana Sugarcane Festival is part of this culture. It's been here 75 years. We have had a bump in the road, and it's become public knowledge what the bump is. But, you know, we got through it, and we're waiting for an official, meaning a legal definition of what we did. It will stand according to what's been said thus far verbally, but we're going to have it written so that way we can stand behind it. But I want to tell you the purpose, which is in our charter. The purpose of the festival is first to foster and to promote, develop the sugarcane industry in the state of Louisiana in all of its various stages, from planning to refining, to stimulate cooperation of all the people residing in the Louisiana Sugar Belt and its movement sponsored by the corporation to accomplish its objectives and purposes. Second, to assist and encourage the advancement of the material prosperity of the Louisiana sugar industry and to aid in its development, progress, and well-being. Third, to promote the agricultural fair exhibits portraying the great agricultural industrial facilities and natural resources abounding in Louisiana and the Sugar Belt. New Iberia is, Iberia Parish is the largest sugar producing parish in the state. And like I said again, 75 years we've been here. And the bump in the road we've had when we critiqued ourselves this past year, it was made a comment at that meeting, and we try to critique ourselves within 3 months, 3 weeks, of our festival. And it was stated normally this past year, the fair was at the Pepperplex. Y'all might have read the paper if you kept up with the paper and all. The Fête aux Dos was gonna be had there. We changed it and had it downtown. But let's go back to the fair where it was located. The fair was located at Pepperplex. Small shower in the afternoon on Friday, small shower again on Saturday. And we lost dearly. For us to put on the festival, it cost us $260,000 to put it on. So it cost money for security, cost money for cleanup. We paid for every school to send their kids to the parades. We sponsored the children's parade. We sponsored school buses to bring people to the parade. We pay for the royalty. We pay for the queens that reside in the hotel rooms here. We pay for the royalty to be escorted. Now you know it costs money. Costs money for the security, costs money for the Fête aux Dos, for the bands to play, and our events that go on, we pay for the catering that goes on there. So it costs money. This year we have the Shadows involved. This past year we had the Shadows involved. They had a farm fest. Worked out wonderful. I think they told me they had, around 400 people that attended with kids and their families. It was terrific. It was just an add-on. The Berry Queens now, they're throwing candy from these little go-karts that go down the road, down the street, And they're participating. So, and you got the Sugar Lumps that dance on Sunday. You know, the Sugar Lumps, that was a 60s group that were dancing. And now you gray-haired and all that other good stuff, but they're dancing on the street for, just to entertain us, but to entertain themselves, it's a good thing for them. So what I'm trying to say in all of this, it's come together where we're all pulling together. Our hiccup, unfortunately, was insecurity. There was some issues that went on between the individual handling the security, and there's no secret of the sheriff. And it looks like we're gonna make amends to all of this, and the sheriff's department is making concessions to use to have them as security. We've had individuals that have businesses downtown that are making concessions for us to use their facilities to host different events. And there's some things we're gonna try to do this year. And that, again, goes back to our board. We're gonna try to involve civic organizations to sell the concessions and the vendors. So we're trying to involve more people within the community to handle the concessions and be more involved and take ownership of the festival. Because it's not Ronnie Gonsalves' festival. It's our festival. It's a community festival. And Larry's there on the side of us pledging some promotional funds that basically come in from y'all, but it's not just for us, it's for the parish. And you need to promote the parish because that is your job. You know, that is your responsibility as well. And the Tourist Bureau, we're finally getting some money coming back from, tax dollars that are gained through sales taxes. And I can thank Frank Thibodeau and her group for that. So all of these things are coming together for the festival. And yes, we had a hiccup, and it was a serious hiccup because people are scared of the liability issues dealing with the fair. Dealing with the festival. And you can't secure one spot for us because the Queens are located in a hotel over here on Highway 14. The parade's going through town, or another event, or that event. Then you got the Fête aux Dos, and then you got the fair. So it's really scattered. You will see an effort from us this year to try to consolidate that, negotiating possibly with the fair, the Sugar Arena, for them, with them. You already heard that I had made a proposal to get it at the airport because we got all that concrete that is really, really not being utilized. and it's an asset to us. Yes, they may put all field equipment on one of these days, the helicopters, but you know what? They ain't there now. So let's try to use it for our benefit, for the benefit of the community. But I will leave you with something that, and it's been stated that y'all are trying to attract young people to stay. You know, that should be one of y'all goals. I'm sure it's y'all goals. But there's a lot of things that has to come together. Why are people leaving? You need to ask them why. You know, is it the attitude? You had a parish president that was basically, you know, not doing much but just attending in presence and physical presence, but he wasn't leading. You had a mayor, she's a lame duck, and we've had some issues with people that served on our festival in relationship to the mayor and to the sheriff. There was some conflict, and it was really some serious conflict. They're not on the board now, so we make an amend. We got a new mayor, and we have a new parish president, and both of them are willing to work with us. But, you know, one of the things you got to create is a sense of community. That's my A thing. You got to have an attitude. You have to have an attitude and an open attitude. Be a part of it. Yeah, we want a little part of it. But you know what? Defend us. Support us. Next is your attitude. And that's going with just, hey, we got the best climate in the world as far as I'm concerned. You can have all the snow and ice. Whoever you want to be, go up there. God dog it, I like it when it's hot. Women are better hot anyway. The jobs, you know, we got jobs in the oil field over here. We got sugar cane, and all those kinds of things. So, you know, we got the jobs. We just got to get the oil field back up. And it looks like who knows what's going to go on. You got a Dow that's almost 20. I don't know if it hit 20,000. I know it retreated some, but it was very, very close to that. So I can tell you that, you know, when that gets going, I know the building of boats is slowing down quite a bit, but it'll get back going. With an attitude that's developing across the country, yeah, we may be one of the last to get a little bit, but you know what? Everybody puts gas in their car or truck and those kind of things, and they all got heat in their house, so it's got to come from somewhere, as an oil and gas are the best source. And the last one is flood insurance, and I know I was a part of that, but I still am a part of it, a big part of it. But you know, there's what they call Acadiana One or One Acadiana. Do not let them take advantage of you. People move from here to go to Youngville to get flooded. Wow, isn't that something? But don't let them dump the water on you, and do not clean a ditch on the north side of the parish until they help you pay for the levee or the security things that you have on this end. They want to do a good thing, be sure you hold that water on them as long as you can so it can trickle down on across us, because it's going to go through us. But we need a levee to protect us from the surges that come through. However way that comes about, it's going to come with some type of a, we got to put some into it. Larry will tell you this, and you'll hear other people that are chairman of the levee district. We're going to have to put some skin in the game to make it count. Got to put skin in the game to make it count. And that's the only way we're going to get money from Washington, and basically from the Gomesa money. You've heard Gomesa. Well, Gomesa is the money that's coming in from the 2017 taxes that are going to come. Instead of going to the USA government, it's going to go to the Louisiana government, and it's allocated to the coastline. And Larry will expound on that and some others in here. So I've pretty much used my time up. But before I go, one of our members wants to make a statement, and I'm going to call up Christy Blanchard right here, and she'd like to address y'all as well. Thank you.
Good evening. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Christy Blanchard. Just wanted to come tonight and support us, the board, as a member. There was a few, maybe you might be concerned that I did comment in the Daily Iberian that I didn't want to make a comment. Just for y'all that are concerned, I'm a farmer's wife. Why would I want it to move? I've been involved with the festival for years. So, the ones that were concerned or are concerned, no, I did not vote to have it moved. The reason I said no comment was because Ronnie asked us to not talk to the Daily Iberian, so that's what I did. So just y'all consider and help us keep it here and talk to everybody, because we wanna do what we can, you know, to keep it here, so. And Ronnie forgot to mention about the livestock. You forgot about the livestock. So we have livestock people out there too. So we don't want any of that to move. So Thank y'all.
We don't want any part of it. We want to keep it all here in the dark.
Anyone else would like to address the council in regards to this topic? We're going to do it during the resolution. Can we do it during the resolution? I'll let questions in the resolution. Okay. Just let the Sugar Cane Board Festival know that we will have a resolution coming up recently. I think a few of the council members has questions.
Yeah, Ricky, I want to thank you all on behalf of the festival for putting that resolution forward. We're making changes to the bylaws, which we'll address at our annual meeting, which will be on January 30th at the festival building. And it's going to pretty much, I guess you want to coattail what you're saying, to keep all events, not just domiciled here, because that's what we are now, just domiciled. We want to put it to where all events will be held in Iberia Parish, less than except those events that we do not have a large enough building to accommodate. And I know y'all working on that.
Okay, thank you, Ronnie. We'll have some questions when it comes up to the resolution. Moving along. Reports and administrative financial action, there is none. Reports from parish or other government agencies. Administration provide a monthly status report on all grants, projects, all in accordance with Resolution 20-12-217. We do have a tabulation of bids open November 29, 2016 for the Cooley Road Bridge, Norris Road Bridge projects. And that will be provided, it will be provided in your January mail out on the proposal. Public Works reports, there are none. Special business, there isn't any. Council member announcements. Any council member here tonight would like to make a comment or have anything to address?
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Gossesan.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to announce to the council and congratulate him personally. Mr. Pat Norris was elected as chairman of the Iberia Parish Airport Authority. I'd like to congratulate him. If you'd like.
Mr. Norris, would you please stand so that you can be recognized? Would you like to make a comment?
Well, first off, I'd like to thank you all for electing me to the commission some year and a half ago. And it's been a good learning experience, and it's given me an opportunity to see what government runs like versus private business. And rest assured, yes, impressive. Rest assured, I was told to take a lot of blood pressure medicines and have a lot of patience, because things don't move quick. But we do have things moving along over there quite well. We've got our terminal that's about to be completed here in January, and hopefully we can have a little social or something to invite y'all and the public and everyone to come out there and see it and kind of give y'all an update of everything that's going on. We've got some positive things that we're working on that's going to help move us forward. Once again, thank y'all for electing me, and thank the commission for electing me chairman last night.
Thank you for volunteering. And make sure the concrete's clean when the fair moves over there. All right. Anyone other council members have any announcements?
Don't let him get away with that. One of the complaints we had is the fuel tanks had to be moved on the, I don't know who rents the building, but you know where the old Gulf Air used to be in Bristol. So we're going to move them another 100 feet so they don't have no complaints.
Right. Any other council members have any announcements for the council?
No.
Hearing none? Yes, I just want to make a quick comment. I'd like to personally thank my wife for attending a meeting tonight with her patience and support. I could never have done this chairman position, so thank you. Hey, would you please stand up? I know I'm in trouble, but she offers a lot of support for me as chair. Thank you. Moving along, Parish President announced. Mr. Richard, you now have the floor.
Okay. Just to make you all aware that our Chief Guy Bonin was appointed by the governor to the Louisiana First Responders Commission, which is a great honor. And if y'all see Guy, make sure y'all tell him congratulations or whatever. It's a great deal. Last Thursday, I guess it was, I visited the Cato Parish administration, and got a lot of good information from them. They're doing a lot of good things out there. One thing that I was impressed with is they have a lot of SOPs, standard operating procedures. Another thing I like about them, they have their legal team on the same floor with the administration. But I went through every department that they have for the most part. I met with the administrator, his name is Dr. Woodrow Wilson, and the assistant is
Mr. Lucky. And so I met with the Public Works Department, the Procurement Department, Nuisance Department, and all the way down. Very, very impressive the way they're doing things up there. I did get a few things from them that I will definitely try to implement in Iberia Parish as time go on. Another thing for your information is Monday we had auditors come into onto the fourth floor to conduct internal controls and preliminary audit work. They completed their work today and they'll be back sometime early next year. Next week we have the Office of Community Development Disaster Recovery Unit. We'll be here for on-site review of files concerning to the Delcom property elevation project, which is something that we started many years ago. But now they have to look at the files to make sure everything that we did is all in compliance. I'm not going to hold you guys. I mean, y'all know what I'm doing. We talk all the time. So if y'all have anything else y'all want to talk about or want me to talk about, let me know. Today I'm not going to go through the Iberia Parish public work completion list where we talk about drainage and trimming trees and shoulder work and patching and things of that nature. But we have a lot going on in the parish and we're moving in the right direction. Thank you.
Mr. Napier, you have a question, Mr. Michaud?
I knew you had something. I don't know if you could explain for the for us and maybe through the paper and the video about recycling is going to continue.
Recycling,
can you explain
is,
that?
Yeah.
What's going to happen? I had a few people ask about that.
As of right now, nothing's changed on recycling. As of right now, we're still using the exact same recycling program we've had. We have like five locations where we're planning on putting recycling bins, where people are going to be able to actually go and drop off their recycling. What's going on right now is we're spending about $310,000 a year on recycling, and we got about 7% participation. And so it's not benefiting the parish.
Right.
When you look at it from that perspective, which we want recycling, because recycling is a big thing. You know, I recycle, but with the amount of money that we're spending, we're not really getting the bang for our buck right now. So with expenses the way they are, we're trying to be a little more creative in what we're doing. And if you remember, Brian, I mentioned when we negotiated the contract that there are some other things that I'm trying to work with the contractor on. And I'm gonna tell you what they are. They're collection points, drop-off points, or collection points like we talked about that some of the other municipalities are doing or parishes are doing, like in Lincoln Parish. When we went visit that, I think I basically talked to most of you all about that. We're trying to do that in Iberia Parish. We would like to do it on property that the parish currently on, and we want to do it throughout the parish, where it's strategically put throughout the parish, where when people want to bring recyclables, or if you have a function that may take place at your house this weekend and your garbage is not picked up until Thursday and you got four garbage cans full of stuff, you can actually go bring it or whatever the case is, and the company will pick it up on a regular basis. So those are the type of things that we're trying to do to make it a little bit better for the residents of the parish. But as far as recycling goes, nothing's changed as of now.
So for now they can still
put their recycling out
like
they've been putting it.
Do.
In fact, I spoke to Mr. Claybo earlier this week, and he had a little recommendation where he thought we can actually put the recycling bins out at these locations. But the problem with what his suggestion was is that they were open top bins, and I'm concerned about doing that because people are going to get used to putting anything in a bin. And once we get the recycling bin at these places, they're going to want to continue to do the same thing. So instead of just going out there and putting some open top bins, we need to do the correct way if we're going to do it.
Right. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Richard.
You're very welcome.
Thank you. Any other questions for Mr. Richard? Move it along. Public comments and ordinance on resolutions. Need a motion to go in public comment?
Move
by Mr. Sir. Brown. Second by Mr. Landry. Roll call. Marty Trahan has stepped out for the record. That motion carries. Anyone in the audience would like to make a comment on any resolution that's on the agenda tonight, please step up to the podium, state your name for the record, and which resolution you're referring to.
My name's Christy Blanchard, and I'd like to comment on resolution 224. We would like and anyone in the public to join our membership for the Louisiana Sugarcane Festival. It's available to join as a member. can contact any one of the 21 board members that sit on there. There's a membership available, and you can find out details, you know, as far as how much it is, and but we would like more people to join the association. Thank you.
Christy?
Yes.
You have a contact number? Contact number?
Sure, I'll give you mine. It's 337-380-5947. We do have a telephone number, but it's an answering machine to the association, so it would be better to contact a board member to get more information, and I probably will be handling the membership, so I guess that's good. Y'all have my number.
Mr. Landry?
Christy, y'all have some openings right now?
I'm sorry?
Do y'all have some openings right now?
For memberships?
Yep.
It's open to anyone. There's no there's no total amount of people that can join the association.
The January 30th meeting, is that open to the public?
Members only.
Members only.
Yeah. And it's the paid members that will be voting if there's any issues that have to be voted on, like if articles or charters are going to be changed or bylaws, anything updated. But the membership, we do our drive in September, August, September, trying to get members, because that's how it's always been. But we're going to try and get the public to start, you know, throughout the year. So, because a membership allows you to vote. So, and that's what we would like.
Tommy Landry?
Yeah, what's the cost of a membership? The cost of the membership?
This past year it was $75. And you get tickets to several events with that membership.
Any other questions for Ms. Blanchard? Thank you, Christy.
Thank you.
Before we move in a little further, I'd like to recognize our newly elected mayor from our city of Iberia, Mr. Frey DeCourt. Thank you for coming tonight and attending. Anyone else wants to address the council in this regards on any issue on the agenda tonight? Oh, I didn't even know you were stepping up, Freddie.
Thank you. good evening. I'm Freddie DeCourt, the mayor-elect of New Iberia. I'd like to also speak on the same item. I just want to let you know that as the mayor-elect, myself, I'm sure I speak for our council as well as for the existing mayor and council. We support the Sugarcane Festival. We, you know, want to see it remain here. We're willing to step up. Attended some meetings with Parish President Richard. I've talked to many of you about it. I mean, it's something that I think is important to our community. So, not that I would ever come to tell you what to do or how to, you know, how to work or how to, you know, do. You know that we are going to work together more than I think any city and parish administration have. Many of you and I have been talking about joint venturing and finding ways to do intergovernmental agreements. I think that this is a good start, just to say, and a good reboot for the Sugarcane Festival. The more of us that get involved and that, you know, show our appreciation, it's been here for over 70 years. It's done wonders. When I think of not having that parade in our historic downtown, you know, it would really be missed, as well as all the other events. So I just wanted to step up and say that, you know, we're in full support, willing to work with you guys any way we can on any issue. But this was one that I fought right from the beginning. I wanted to come and just tell y'all hi, tell you I'm coming, and show our support for the festival. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Frederson. Some encouraging words. Also, Mr. Swear, Mr. Lewis is in the audience tonight. Some new elected city council members. Thank y'all for attending. Anyone else would like to address an item on the agenda? Please step up.
And yes, state your name for the record. 224. Name's Randy Gonsolin. I live at 408 Estate Drive. The festival has meaning to me. I can remember when I was really young, myself and my brother. We were probably in the second and fifth grade, and we walked in the children's parade. Since then, we saw our children walk in the children's parade. Since then, we've seen our grandchildren walk in the children's parade. And probably very many of you in here saw your children. Not to say that any of you have any grandchildren at this point in time, but a lot of children have walked in that parade and like to see them continue. Both of us raised pigs. We got involved with the animals, raising the sugar cane, getting in the contest, and I'd hate to see all that disappear. Keep it in your Iberia. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else would like to address the council on any resolution on the agenda tonight? Step up to the podium, state the number of the resolution, and your name for the record. Hearing none, I got a motion to move out of public. Move by Mr. Gosselin, second by Mr. Paul Landry. Roll call.
Mr.
Ordinance for introduction to public, I mean, excuse me. Since we have keen interest in the Sugar Cane Festival tonight, it seems like that we'll go ahead and move that ordinance to the top of the agenda. So just a little change in the order. We'll go to summary number 224, introduced by Ricky J. Gonsolin, District 8. A resolution encouraging the Louisiana Sugar Cane Festival and Fair Association to continue the tradition of hosting all related activities of the Sugar Cane Festival, including but not limited to the street fair, royalty events, children's and queen's parades, arts, garden, and cooking competition, etc., in Iberia Parish.
Move.
Moved by Mr. Davis.
Unanimous second.
Unanimous second. Any comment by any council members?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Trahan?
I'd like to say I'm in total support of this, in that if y'all need any help, I'm willing to go to the table to help y'all negotiate and whatever y'all need to do. And I appreciate y'all serving it as members and giving up y'all time to make this happen. Thank y'all.
Any other comments before I acknowledge the unanimous second? I'd like to make one comment. I'd like to say that this is an extremely sweet decision by the Board of Directors of the Sugar Cane Festival. This is part of the history of this parish. It's not only important to me, but important to everybody in this community. And I can guarantee you that this council will offer an overwhelming support to whatever we can do to assist. Thank you all. Roll call.
I make a comment.
Unanimous second. Oh, Mr. Richard, I'm sorry.
Oh, mine's going to be sharp because I think mine was already in the newspaper, so that's my comment.
Thank you, Mr. Richard. Roll call. That motion carries. Moving back to the top of the agenda. Summary number 4774, introduced by Warren P. Gosselin, District 5, an ordinance to repeal Section 2-6 of the compiled ordinance of Iberia Parish to allow that all items placed on the council meeting agenda must be recommended by committee. Note, substitute motion could be made to include resolution summary 221 with this ordinance.
Move, Mr. Chairman.
Moved by Mr. Gosselin.
Second.
Second by Mr. Napier. Discussion. Mr. Gosselin, you have the floor.
You want to do it on this particular one?
I think so. Mr. Seeley?
Yes. Thank y'all. I would like for y'all to consider taking up summary 4774 as well as 221 at the same time. I initially prepared those as two separate documents, but after giving some consideration, I think it's better to just combine them into one. Today, I ask Ms. Bergeron to send to each of you a draft of substitute ordinance that I prepared. And it combines both of those into one ordinance. But basically, what it does is there's two sections of your code of ordinances that we're dealing with. Section 2-3, which is your rules of order. You've already adopted Robert's Rules of Order, and this simply readopts, for lack of a better term, Robert's Rules of Order. But it also begins to try to bring everything together. There are some times when Robert's Rules of Order is not appropriate because of it conflicting with state law and state open meetings laws and specifically. And so there are also times when you might choose a better procedural vehicle than Robert's Rules of Order. And so what I've done in Section 2-3 is to begin a compilation of those special situations that you want to handle differently than Robert's Rules of Order. And the first one we've had trouble with, and we had a discussion about this, and this is one that I think Mr. Gotchesand has had special interest in, and that's substitute motions. Mr. Gosselin knows from sitting in that chair he sits in that substitute motions create a special problem, a special dilemma. And so what we have suggested is to limit the amount of substitute motions that can be made, because what happens is a substitute for the substitute, and it begins to become, it blurs the lines of what are we really voting on, what is our order. And so I think most of you, when we had this discussed in committee meeting, clearly recognized that it, creates a problem sometimes. And so what this 2-3 does is says that, number one, you can only have 5 substitute motions on an item. Now, substitute motion is different than a motion to amend. And so what we're and not only that, when you make a substitute motion, you're going to vote on that motion before you're going to take another substitute motion. And I think that that will allow you to concentrate on and not be confused about what you vote on. I think it'll make Mr. Gosselin's life a whole lot easier also, or whoever might be sitting in that particular chair. So I guess I didn't know if there were any other questions on that particular part of it. And I would go on to say that we included the provision that a majority of the members of the council can always suspend the rules for a particular item if it meets your needs. I don't know if you'd rather me talk about them one at a time or if you want me to go on to section 2-6, which relates to items failing in committee. As it stands right now, even though an item fails in committee, it can be moved forward to a regular meeting by any member of the council. Y'all have all worked very hard to try to conduct your meetings in a logical, expedient manner, and I think most of you have decided if a matter fails in committee, there's no reason for it to be put on the agenda until the issues have been worked out. And so section 2-6 will provide that once a matter fails in committee, it cannot be brought back to the committee until 90 days unless, now look, we don't want to stop you if there's been a substantial change. If the issues that were raised have been resolved and you want to bring it back, that's fine. We just simply don't want to see the same items just keep coming back until it's been worked on, until y'all have kind of reached a consensus of how it's to be handled. That is basically what this ordinance does, and I'll be glad to answer any questions that any of you might have.
Mr. Gosselin, you still have the floor?
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, Mr. Shealy, when we continue to say acted, I got an issue with that, because the fact is, what happens if, I'm a good friend here, but if Mr. Landry makes a substitute motion and then he withdraws the substitute motion, even when you're saying acted, we're talking about favorable vote acted, or we're talking about acted as in debate?
I think if it's withdrawn, it's not active.
Yeah. No, because if he made a substitute motion and there was a second and he withdrew it, well, that doesn't mean that discussion wasn't talked about and acted on.
Right.
So because acted to me is discussed. We're discussed.
So you're saying it's counted as two.
Right.
Okay.
So that's why I'm asking if, you know, acted or should we put voted? Because, you know, he can have a substitute motion and then we discuss it and then he withdraws his substitute motion. So how does that react?
Well, I think that's a good question, and it also helps us think through this. But I think if you look at C2, in the first sentence, or first, third sentence, I guess, second sentence, it talks about acted upon. But then it goes forward to say that if no substitute motion receives a favorable vote. So I believe we're talking about those substitute motions that do not receive a favorable vote of the majority of the members of the council.
Okay. Also, on this page, I don't see where it says we could suspend the rules in the sections. I know on the first one we drafted, they had the suspension of the rules in each of the individual ones.
It's in B.
Where?
Yeah. However, any rule or rules for conducting meetings.
Okay, so the waiver upon a favor, and that's where the issue comes for me too. It says to suspend or waiver or waive upon a favorable vote. It has to be 2/3 of the vote to suspend under the Robert rules.
It does, but this is a governmental body, and that's correct. Why I've said sometimes Robert's rules of order doesn't fit you very well.
Correct.
If a majority of you want to move forward on an issue, I don't want procedure to get into the way of accomplishing something. And so that's why I suggested, again, that's not my decision. That was my suggestion, that if you want to suspend the rules and you do it by majority, that's a pretty good indication that the action you ultimately are going to take is going to get a majority vote and pass.
I just want to make sure, because I know on the, let's say the we pass something here in the council and it passed by 8 votes, and the president would decide to veto it, then it becomes about veto power, 2/3 vote of the council to override the president's veto. So I want to kind of be, if we need to be in line, I mean, it's an act of the assembly to send out a reform resolution. So I just want to make sure. So I mean, it's all about what the council wants to do, but I mean, I just thought that could be a consideration. It says favorable vote. I think it should be 2/3 favorable vote, but that's just me.
Any other questions on the floor?
I do want to make one more comment, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Gosselin?
Mr. Sheila, I appreciate the help and support of getting through this. I know sometimes we didn't agree, but some things we did agree on, and I think this sets a precedent for us to continue to move forward with efficiency here and within this this committee.
Mr. Olivier?
I always like the idea of a second substitute when it's put on the floor, give each one of us an option, 3 options to actually vote on, to consider when we're voting on these motions. I understand what's happening here, but it's an incumbent of the chair to make sure that everyone's voice here is heard before that substitute motion is voted on. I, for one, will sometime enact ideas for another substitute motion in that discussion where you need to know that I plan on bringing up another substitute motion if this one fails. I want to make sure, as chair, to give each one of us an opportunity to voice our opinion about any possibility of another substitute motion that's going to be brought to the floor. Okay? Not to shut us down with this one substitute and say, look, that's it, no discussion, let's vote on it. All right? I want to be fair. All right? Yeah. Thank you.
Well, according to the new ordinance, you have 5. You know, once 5, it will be over with, according to this ordinance. So
once you vote on the substitute and it passes, that shuts the whole thing down. But I want each one of us to have an opportunity to voice an opinion about that second substitute.
Okay. You're during discussion time. Mr. Brown and Mr. Gosselin.
I kind of see what Eugene is talking about. But, Eugene, I think we could kind of do that with discussion.
Exactly.
You know, I think if we do the discussion, that would allow us to say what we want to say on that substitute motion. I don't see why we need to go any further before we do it, because it does cause a problem.
Mr. Brown, you finished?
Yeah, I'm done.
Okay. Mr. Gosselin?
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, the gentleman raises a good point, but I think the 2 tactics that we're talking about, I use tactics, but it's become political tactics here on both sides of the issues of using substitutions, either to one of 2 reasons, to beat it to the punch, or number 2, to be the last to speak with the option to continue to use the power of, I can't even think right now, Mr. Chairman. Use the power of to filibust, and I'm one that likes to do that, to continue to do it, and my colleagues appreciate that, and it's one of the issues. But I think, Mr. Chairman, particularly this serves as an even option of playing rules for all of us. We all get the opportunity to have discussion spoke during the original motion when it's being entertained, and I think the substitute motion becomes about now relatively to significant change, and that's where we've, along the line, some of the members have lost the ability to determine amend to or substitute to. So I think this is a good start to have an even playing field.
Thank you, Mr. Gosselin. Mr. Traha?
Okay. Say Warren puts up a resolution and we're in discussion. Can I amend his resolution?
Yeah.
Say in habit of.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Mr. Seeley.
Let me try to answer 2 questions, yours, Mr. Tron's, as well as Mr. Olivier's. This is not in any way designed to have a chilling effect on your debate or your ability to express your opinion. For instance, Mr. Gotchasan may make a motion. Mr. Brown may make a substitute motion. Mr. Gotchasan wanted something to terminate in 2017, Mr. Brown in 2018. There's nothing wrong with you during that debate, Mr. Olivier, saying, well, look, I really would like to see this go to 20, so I'm not in favor of 2019. You still have that ability. We're not trying to change that at all. We're simply just trying to focus the debate and the votes to have a little bit more clarity. With respect to Mr. Trahan's question, we are certainly not trying to limit the number of amendments that you can make. You're going to have some ordinances that are lengthy, that have many sections to them. You may choose to go section by section. You may choose to look at section one, and there may be four different motions of how to amend that. That's not what we're trying to deal with. We're trying to deal with the substitute motions where somebody's trying to substitute your motion. Let's just, when a motion's made, let's try to vote on it, see where the membership stands, another one until we get to the point. It's not meant to say that you can only have five chances to amend a very difficult motion. I hope that answers your question.
What I was trying to say, Eugene, and I see this, is that he makes a motion. So while in discussion, we'd have to ask whoever made the resolution if he can amend it, and would that have to have a second to it to amend his resolution? In case of, like what you said, from 2017 to 2020, we want to extend it. Would that be the proper way to address it on the floor as an amendment and not a resolution to the resolution?
Well, the proper way is if Mr. Gotchison wants to make a change, he makes a motion, but he's got to have a second before y'all can ever even begin to discuss it. If he gets a second, then what happens is somebody says, oh, well, I want to make a substitute motion. And then that substitute motion, unless it gets a second, it dies. If it gets a second, then it becomes the matter you're voting on. So you vote on that one, and then it could be somebody else makes another one. There have been times where it's been substitute after substitute after substitute, and it's... you folks are pretty smart. I've been sitting here watching you, and it doesn't take but about two or three motions before you got a pretty good idea of what the majority of you are thinking. And we're just trying to suggest a way that might be the most efficient. And look, if this becomes a problem and it interferes with your ability to really fully debate, then you can easily change it. We just thought this was a start toward trying to streamline and simplify your voting process.
Mr. Gotchison, one more time.
Oh, yeah. Mr. Chairman, I think Marty does raise a good point, but I think also the substitute motion has been used previously about making the discussion turn all over again about the main motion. Usually when a substitute motion is formed, it's formed because we're changing the way the main motion becomes. So if we're buying computers on the main motion, it becomes, is it new or used in the substitute motion? And that becomes the discussion. But it seems like sometimes we do it as far as making points are relatively to the debate of the same main motion.
You real?
Yeah, I'm done.
Okay. Just one brief comment. I think, thank you, Mr. Seeley, for drafting this. I think it's an important addition to our meetings. I think we've been really efficient in the past. You know, a couple of times we had a controversial issue that may have had a trump card, and I can assure you that sitting in this seat as chairman, that it gets very difficult trying to remember every substitute. But I will say that with the new resolution we passed with the ordinance on conducting a meeting with two committee meetings, we should be able to eliminate a lot of those substitutes. So I'm hoping that with two committee meetings, we'll have a detailed discussion, and we should be able to iron out all the details, and the full council meetings will go smooth. Ms. Broussard?
I'd like to amend summary number 4774 and resolution
221
to the proposal that we were presented by Mr. Shuling.
I got a substitute motion on the floor to amend it. Second by Mr. Paul Landry. Discussion? Roll call. That motion carries. Summary number 178, introduced by Brian P. Napier, District 11, a resolution appointing Mr. John Bellefontaine to the Generette Indigent Defendant Ford Board, representing Iberia Parish Council, all as required by Act 638 of the 2016 regular session of the Louisiana Legislature.
Move.
Second.
Roll call.
Stated.
Napier, and move by Mr. Napier, second by Ms. Broussard. Roll call.
Is Mr. Fontaine here?
Is Mr. Bellefontaine here?
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Napier? That motion carries.
Mr. Bellefontaine called me tonight. He was going to come. He was caught in court today and was tied up. So he wanted me to thank the council for putting our trust in him, and he's going to serve as best as he can. And he wanted me just to pass on thanks to all of y'all for allowing him to serve. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Napier. Summary number 220, introduced by Berwick Francis Jr., District 12, a resolution to establish the following channels as a watershed channel in Iberia Parish as follows. Channel L-1C-2, District 12, 35-foot width on each side.
Move.
Move by Mr. Second. Francis, second by Ms. Broussard. Discussion. Mr. Francis.
Mr. Chairman, I like that. We actually have a meeting with legal and administration to finish up on a couple loose ends before we proceed with this matter. I would like to make a motion to table it to the next full council meeting, December 28th.
Okay. Mr. Francis is requesting that we table it until December 28th. Second. And second by Mr. Brown. Discussion? Roll call. That motion.
Who didn't vote?
Davis, please vote.
Please.
That motion carries. Summary number 221, introduced by Warren P. Gosselin Jr., District 5. A resolution establishing a rule of Iberia Parish Council allowing or permitting no more than a total of 5 motions to amend or substitute motion, receiving a second to be considered in connection with the agenda item and otherwise to provide a respect thereof.
Move to delete, Mr. Chairman.
Second. That motion to delete.
Second.
Second by Mr. Trahan. Roll call. That motion carries. Summary number 222, introduced by the Clerk of the Council. A resolution authorizing a contract with the For the Record Video Service, LLC, DBA, Bob Laracini Productions for video of the council meetings for a 1-year period effective January 1st through December 31st, 2017.
Move.
Move by Mr. Gosselin.
Second.
Second.
This is For the Record. And second by Mr. Napier. I just call him Video Bob.
So Video Bob.
Roll call. Oh, Mr. Davis, I got you.
Thank you.
You're coming. A little slow tonight, Mr. Davis. That motion carries.
I'm on my mind.
Let it out.
Summary number 223, introduced by the Clerk of the Council, a resolution announcing the regular meetings of Iberia Parish Council to be held for the fiscal year 2017.
Move.
Move by Ms. Broussard. Second by Mr. Brown. Roll call. Warren. Summary number 224 has been discussed and voted upon. Summary number 225, introduced by the Clerk of the Council, a resolution approving and accepting the 2017 the Acadiana Crime Lab Fund Budget of Revenues and Expenditures, all as recommended by the Acadiana Crime Lab Commission.
Move.
Move by Ms. Broussard.
Second.
Second by Mr. Paul Landry. Discussion. Roll call. That motion carries. Summary number 226, introduced by Warren P. Gosselin Jr., District 5, a resolution authorizing travel expenses to attend the Police Jury Association of Louisiana 93rd Annual Conference to be held in Lake Charles, Louisiana for February 15th to 17th, 2017 at the approximate cost of $985 per attendee to defund it completely the four members.
Move.
Move by Mr. Landry.
Second.
Second by Mr. Napier. Discussion.
I'd like to.
Mr. Trahan.
With summary number 226, In the last 4 years, 5 years, I attended every one of them. Mr. Bernard and Glenn took me to these meetings, and they introduced me to people that we need to work together, okay? Especially for a coastal district. They have a PAC up there at the state level that watches all these funds, and we work together as a team. We go after the money as a team. With 9 new ones, I would like to offer, I don't want to restrict who goes. And I would like for that to come to a vote where we each vote our conviction, okay? And if it doesn't pass, I accept that vote. But y'all, it's a learning curve, just like this last 10 months has been a learning curve for y'all, 11 months, okay? I take time off from my regular job to do the meetings during the week, like the Regional Drainage Authority. Y'all could ask Scott and Larry. I attend them. It's something going on with my district. I don't charge for that. I figure that comes out of the $600 I paid, okay? But to go to this convention, I would like to offer a resolution that the policy we have, we got to pay for it ahead of time, okay? I would like to where we vote on it. And if I don't feel I have to turn in my meals, it's still a saving to the parish, you know? I would just like that to come to a vote, and if they got a substitute, I don't mind. I'll go with the majority rules, you know, just like Burry to learn. Me and him talked last night. I'd like to take him, go introduce him to these people. Like the Regional Drainage Authority, when I showed up in the meeting, I knew all these people. I didn't have to go introduce myself. You know, and I could state my opinion, and they respected it. Some took, some didn't. You know, so I just wanna, I don't wanna have a long discussion. I would like to offer a substitute resolution to follow our policy, and it becomes each of ours whether we want to turn in our receipts or none of our receipts. And rest at that. I'm making a motion.
I'll second it.
Okay. So we got a motion by Mr. Strong, second by Mr. Brown. Make sure I have this correct.
Mr. Chairman, before you move forward, can you
discussion?
Discussion. Yeah.
I was gonna. I was gonna state it for the record. Mr. Strong, correct me if I'm wrong, but you want to a substitute motion to amend this motion to follow the previous resolution stated by Berry Parish Council and maintaining $15,000 in the budget, and letting the council members decide on what benefits they want to receive if they attend the conference. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. Discussion. Discussing.
I don't think you gave discussion for the main motion yet. He made a substitute motion. Are you holding the substitute motion?
Holding the substitute
motion. Okay, I didn't.
I'm holding the substitute motion. So I just want to clarify what he was for the record. Any discussion?
Clarification. I was just wondering, like, with the four members at the end of that resolution, is that saying like?
That's the original motion. That's what you're referring to, the original motion.
Yeah. Where was some clarification?
Okay.
It was like pretty much like when we're saying the four members at the end, is it the defunded four members that were going on?
It's not what he said.
Oh, no, I'm sorry.
We got to be going with what he said.
No, it's the main motion.
We're discussing the main motion. Is Berwick's addressing the main motion currently. Okay, the substitute motion is on hold right now. Okay, so we're discussing the main motion. Berwick, to clarify it, in committee meeting, I don't remember who made a motion. They wanted to fund only four individuals to the conference.
Okay.
And that's what the council moved to move it to committee to defund the travel expenses, and other council members wanted to fund four members. So
we're looking to defund the four members as well, or just to send the four members? That's why I kind of.
The main motion is to defund it.
Okay. All right.
No money.
Okay.
That's for the main motion. Okay.
Thank you, Jim.
We're going to vote on the substitute.
Yeah, we'll vote on the substitute first, but we're discussing the main motion currently. The substitute motion is on hold.
You want it? Are you up? If not, up.
No, go ahead.
Okay, I got Mr. Landry on this side.
I can understand that, Marty, and everything, but the problem is we just come out of budget, and this council needs to learn to lead by example. Mm-hmm. And I think we just need to go and if somebody makes a substitute motion that the registration is paid, I would go for that. That's only $275 a person. I think that's fair. But for anything else, I'm going to vote no. I think it's time for us to lead by example, to show all those people that work for the parish that we're going to take our lumps too. And I am for conventions. I believe in them. You know, I've went to a lot of them, and I've always paid my way. This was the first time I've ever had anybody pick up my tab, but I'm willing to, you know, to go that, but I can't support that motion.
Okay, Mr. Landry, going up. Mr. Brown, did you request for speak?
On which one y'all talk?
We talk about main motion.
The main motion. No,
okay.
I don't have anything right now.
Okay, Mr. Napier.
Okay. Boy, this is tough, Marty. I feel what you're saying. And I did, just coming in a month, as several of us in February, we attended in Shreveport, and I'm going to tell you, it was very informative. If you go there with the intention to sit in these seminars, you learn a lot, and you network with a lot of people around the state. So I'm like Paul, I believe in them, and I think we should go, but because of what we've learned since February to now, the money situation is totally different, and we have to answer to those taxpayers that are watching us, and believe me, they are watching us. For this year, as far as I'm concerned, I'm not going to support anything where it's going to cost the taxpayers. If we want to go, and I think there's been a few of us that said, hey, we'll go, we'll pick up our own tab, so that, don't think that Iberia Passion can be represented if we vote not to fund it. The only thing I would, I'll take that back, I would support the registration. But as far as for the lodging, meals, stuff like that, to answer to my constituents, I can't support that.
Thank you, Mr. Napier. Mr. Olivier.
I can't stress the importance of these conferences. The Education Opportunities Conference Office, I think, is something each one of us needs to attend these conferences. I understand the financial hardship the parish is in, but I don't think we're in that dire need. We can't fund at least a percentage of our budget for this conference. Marty's motion that's on the floor, I can support it because I really think it's important for us to attend these meetings. But I am prepared to make another substitute motion if it fails, the majority of us fail. Okay? But I would consider Marty's motion on the floor as well. And, I will support his motion at this time.
Okay, Mr. Davis?
Yes. I agree with him to a certain extent what Paul said, but I'm going to make a statement. When we went to Shreveport, I didn't turn in a bunch to go other come, and I went. But that just me. I can't speak for nobody else. But I did cut back, and we didn't have the budget at the time. I think if they want, see who want to go. If you going to represent Iberia Parish, we should pick up the tab. Because they're not going, we're not going there for ourselves, and I don't want to go. But if somebody else want to go, I think we should pick up the tab because they're going to represent Iberia Parish. Not his personal business, not her personal business. We going there to represent Iberia Parish. That's how I feel about it.
Thank you, Mr. Davis. Mr. Trahan.
Yes. Also, on the executive board, Iberia Parish has been represented since Will Long Lane. Mr. Freeman, that's now on the levy board, Bernard, Glenn, we always had a vote on the state board, okay? When Bernard and Glenn left, they went. I have picked up to run for that. I think this was my third year I ran, and I'm currently running again. I've announced that I'm running again for the state board, to where we can watch what's going on in the state, and we can go to Baton Rouge. We could have a voice in Baton Rouge, okay? You know, I was elected. I take my calls. We pay our own phone bills. I do the meetings, you know, that I think pertain to us, you know. I just think we should have a choice that we can go. And we have to pay for it up front, right, Tim? We have to pay for it up front, totally. The motel rooms and everything, right?
The registration is paid up front by the council. I believe it's the first night that's reserved, but everything else.
The last time. Yeah, we had to pay for everything.
The first night.
No.
Well, why did I have to put my credit card at
the
motel?
For the second night.
You pay everything but the first one, and then you get reimbursed.
Yeah.
Hey, that's not germane with the topic.
Wait. Ricky, excuse
me. Stay germane, okay?
I had to fight $2,000 because they charged my card twice, okay? I'm not bringing that up.
Okay.
We paid for it up front, okay?
That's a procedural thing, but
okay. Yeah. I just want y'all to understand. I don't go to these conventions to play. I mean, I've learned. I know we can go with sewer district and get some money from DEQ to fund, to bond out. You know, talking to other people like Bossier City, they put in a new sewer system. So, I mean, it's not all play, you know. It's working together with people to find out what they're doing and that might work for us. Thank you. Appreciate whatever okay. y'all think.
Okay. Any other discussion on the main motion?
I got one.
Okay. Mr. Brown?
You know, I want to address Mr. Nathan. He said that, you know, it's the your people that's after you because of the money. I hope it's not the one that want the video poker. Because I could see where we're going that we.
Mr. Brown, video poker's not on the agenda.
I don't know what that means.
That's not on the agenda, Brown.
We need somebody at the table. That we're going to need some help to get this over here.
Okay.
You know, because it don't, a lot of y'all think that it started here, but it need more than here for that to come. The next thing is that we don't have, we're getting ready to fund a convention here, Region 3, a meeting. And we don't have not one of us that's on that that's on that board. Not one of them.
Yeah, I'm the vice chair.
You're not on the board.
No, but I'm the vice chair.
Okay, you're the vice chair, but you're not on the board.
Okay.
But we gonna fund the whole thing. And that is because of us not being at the meeting, that we couldn't, we didn't have a voice, so that we could have a representative to be on the board, and we lost two of them. But no, by not being to the meeting, nobody gonna give us nothing if we're not there to get it. That's all I'm telling you.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Mr. Tron?
I'd like to call for the vote. Call for the question.
We're on the stuck. We're talking about the main motion of.
I don't want this to hash out in public.
Okay.
I really like to vote.
You have a issue with the main motion, Mr. Levy?
Not the substitute motion.
I'll open it. Okay, Mr. Napier.
No
main motion.
No.
Okay, I'll open up discussion on the substitute motion that Mr. Trahan made. Any discussion on substitute motion? Mr. Levy.
I like to test the new resolution tonight. I'm not going to make a substitute to the substitute until we vote on his resolution. Okay. But for discussion point, I am ready to put up another resolution if his resolution fails. I would like to see the budget, line item budget, reduced from the $14,000 it would normally cost to send every council member to this conference to $6,000. That's a 60% reduction. And in that $6,000, anyone that would like to go, will divide that money between, say it's 10 people that's gone, We'll divide $6,000 by 10, which is $600 a piece per person. That's what they allow us going to be to go to the conference if his proposal fails. I'm prepared to make that substitution.
Okay, we're discussion on Marty's substitute motion. Any more discussion on Marty's substitute motion? Oh, Ms. Broussard.
I'm concerned about us going back to putting all of the funding back in that would be available just for this state convention. We do not have any other funding available to pay for the Regional 3 meeting. I think we need to keep some of the money in this budget available for the Regional 3 meeting. We also have other travel expenses that we're not discussing at all. As far as we just got the email regarding the millage classes, we have to travel to go to ethics classes. So, I mean, I think we're where we are budget-wise, and I don't think it's wise of us to spend the taxpayers' money sending all of us or paying for all of us using $14,000-$15,000 in the budget to go to the state convention. I'm with everybody that we need to be at the table, and the conventions are very important, and we will be represented. I know our administration is going to be there, and there's going to be council members that are willing to pay out of pocket and attend. And so I can't support your motion, Marty.
All right. That's
okay. Mr. Landry.
Let's cut to the chase, okay? How many people are going to the convention? So we'll have an idea how much money we're looking at, okay? People who want Iberia, who are considering Iberia Parishes to pay for their trip. Okay? So, okay. Paul, okay. 1, 2, 3.
No,
four.
Paul, okay. He's saying, do you want Iberia Parishes to pay for
you? No, he's asking.
No, I'm
who's
asking.
Going?
Who's going to have
look,
Iberia
just.
Who's going to have
Mr. Iberia Landry requested a show of hands of who's attending.
Who's
just
attending?
Count who's attending.
Okay.
Just who's attending.
Who wants to go to conference?
Who wants to go? Okay. So we
who
have
has an
one,
interest of going to council.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There's 7 of us, okay? So what are we looking at as it relates to cost?
$7,000,
all right? So we have an idea what we're looking at.
Okay.
And Mr. Eugene Olivier's proposal was.
That's not on the record.
Not on it, but just in general discussion, mm-hmm. Okay? He's looking at $1,000 less, all right?
Okay.
Just something to think about. So, and
you want
to
call Mr. Dashasan?
You were done, Mr. Landry?
Yes.
He raised
Mr. Chairman, I told a few of my colleagues I probably wouldn't have commented on this tonight, but this has got out of hand, Mr. Chairman. Okay. I mean, we sat here and we discussed for 20 minutes about how we're going to travel and why should we travel and why should the taxpayers pay for us to travel. Yet when it comes down to resolutions where we need to fund certain items and drainage and dredging and things of that nature, we sit there, all we do is with our hands folded and require we vote. But yet we're spending so much time today, and I feel bad that tomorrow that the people of this parish are going to wake up and read the newspaper to know that their parish council spent almost 30 minutes discussing whether or not how many people we're going to fund to travel. That's pathetic, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. Thank you for your comments. Mr. Davis?
Well, Mr. Gosser said he talked to his colleague. What colleague did he talk to?
It wasn't you, Mr. Yep. Davis.
I know it wasn't me. That's why I'm asking.
Hey, Mr. Davis has the floor. Mr. Gosser.
Sure.
Finish.
I want to know what colleague did he talk to? What they came up with? Who did he talk to?
I have Mr. Gosser.
Mr. Chairman, again, it doesn't matter who I talk to. What matters, Mr. Chairman, is that at the end of the day, we're running low on funds and that we're trying to still send everybody there. Mr. Chairman, while I'm gonna say this, a couple of us, one of us has been to Washington, several of us have been to California on the taxpayers, several of us have been to Lake Charles before already this year. So to say that we aren't sending our people there, that's misinforming the people. We are going. We have sent people. But now that things are tightening up, Mr. Chairman, everyone's hoo-wowing about, oh man, we're cutting back on things of that nature. How about the people that is in public works that make very little money that we cut to 2.5%? How about Brenda, your travel expenses, sometimes we try to take a car from you, haven't we not, for you to go back and forth and do council business. So Mr. Landry, you are accurate. We are taking, it's time for us to absorb some of that cut too. I agree with you, Mr. Landry.
Okay.
And you know what? Me saying that's probably going to make some of my colleagues upset. But at the end of the day, it's the principle. If we do for all, we got to do for us too.
Mr. Brown?
Yeah, you know, bring a good plan.
I do, Mr. Brown. Thank you.
What I'm willing to say is that whatever money we don't take, let's give our public work that 2%, 2.5%.
That's done, man. Come on.
Yeah, I'm going to say it.
I got a call for the question on the floor. Mr. Strong, do I have a second?
Tell us what we do.
Second, Mr. Landry. Roll call. Yeah, that's all the clear the board. I have a call for the question, a second by Mr. Landry, voting on for the call for the question.
No, wait, what we voting on?
Voting on.
To end discussion.
To end discussion.
Oh, voting on end discussion?
That motion carries. Now on the substitute motion.
Made by who?
By Mr. Trahan.
Can we, I'm sorry.
Restate the substitute.
Morty. Morty Trahan, okay. For the clarification purpose, the substitute motion. No, that's fine. I'm glad you asked, Mr. Francis. The substitute motion states that Ms. Trahan wants to follow original procedure by Berry Parish government to fund anyone who was wishing to go to the conference and remain, leave the $15,000 in the budget.
At a cost of
$985 per person. That was the substitute. We have the question on the floor. I'm sorry, Marty.
No, that's good. That's
roll call.
She's going to tell me. That's all I want. I'm happy with it.
That motion fails.
Any motion.
Now we're going back to the main motion.
I'd like to pose a substitute.
Okay, you got a, Mr. Louvier, you got the floor.
Okay. I would like to fund a budget of $6,000 for the conference in Lake Charles. If seven people is gone, that's going to give the seven people $857 each to spend at the conference.
Okay, hold on. Okay.
But my alternative is this: we're going to max. The expense at $600 per council member to go to the conference. So I would like to see as many people as possible to go to the conference. Let's just do a budget of $6,000 for the Lake Charles conference, and anybody wants to go will divide the amount of people attending by the $6,000 up to a maximum of $600 per person.
Okay. Do you have a second?
Second
by Mr. Davis. Discussion. Mr. Landry?
Yeah, I see where you're coming from, Eugene, but I still can't go that much. I mean, I think we got to lead by example for these people. And
60% reduction.
I understand. Let's go 100% reduction.
Second that.
Okay, Mr. Gottstein?
Yeah, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Eugene, I have tons of respect for you, sir. But I mean, going back, what happened to the days of compromising, sir? What happened to most of us? It doesn't take 14 people to figure out what drainage shed that they're doing in Baton Rouge. I just, one of these things is in the case is, I know Marty has a rural area, so I can understand the fight of that. But why don't we get this fight on every agenda item that we get? Why does it have to be on when it's incentive for going somewhere? That's what's mind-boggling for me, and that's what's sad to see this happen today. I can't support that.
Mr. Trahan.
What would it take for y'all to support something? What's y'all
numbers? That's not what's on the floor. We have a substitute motion to fund 6,000.
Well, then I want another substitute motion.
Andy, we did a good thing, man.
Yeah, I'm seeing.
Ms. Broussard.
Mr. Trahan, I'll answer the question.
I still got the floor.
Okay, Ms. Trahan.
I'd like to see us negotiate and come to a real number between all of us, okay? This shouldn't be back and forth. Never intended it to go back and forth.
That's
Broussard.
I think the what we could support is, or let me not say we, because I'm not speaking for anybody else, but for me, would be the registration fee. So I'll make a substitute motion to Mr. Eugene's motion and cap it at $275 per person.
So I have a second on the substitute motion to the substitute.
I second that.
Mr. Napier second that discussion on the substitute to the substitute. Mr. Napier?
Okay, so, all right.
Thank you.
this way. So the registration is $285, Mr. Chairman, I think you said, for every member. So I can support that. Anything else? You want to go? I think some said that they were going to go, and I was one of them, and I'll pay my full amount. So to say that we got to negotiate to try to get how much money we're going to spend out the coffers, $275 is the most I can go, and that'll be registration. We pick up our own hotel, pay our own meals, pay our own fuel. I can support that, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
Is it
275?
That's where it is, 275.
I just want to clear for the
subject. Yeah. Minute we go now.
Is that 275 times 7?
Just one clarification, Mr. Napier.
Sure.
It's
275. 275. Mr. Napier, 275.
275.
So I have a substitute motion, and we're in discussion to pay the 275 registration fee for the council to go to Lake Charles. Do you have any more discussion? Roll call. That motion fails. Now back to the substitute motion to the original motion, Mr. Olivier, to appropriate $6,000.
To the board.
Hold on, clerk's counting. You got it? Okay. Now we're on this substitute motion to the original motion of Mr. Olivier's appropriation of $6,000 to appropriate any member that wishes to attend the Lake Charles Conference in 2016. Is that correct, Mr. Levy?
That's correct.
Any discussion? Roll
clear
call. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Scott.
Clear the board.
Clear the board.
Yeah.
Roll call.
Yes, sir.
That motion fails.
Eugene?
Back to the original motion to defund all travel expenses to Lake Charles. Except the $15,000 for the convention. No, that's right. Just defund the travel expenses to Lake Charles.
It's defunded totally.
Totally, yes. Any discussion? Roll call. That motion fails.
Make a substitute motion.
Whoa.
That was the original motion. It failed. It's dead.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
I'll read.
That motion fails.
Well, we might as well did a
resolution. Can we suspend the rules and come with another resolution?
No.
He can reconsider.
I'm asking.
He can rescind the vote, but there was no vote that was unfavorable. So,
listen.
I think Marty voted wrong.
Andy, one of the nay votes can ask to reconsider, correct? That's what I thought. So one of the nay vote, if you voted no on the original motion, you can ask to reconsider from the chair.
Ask to reconsider.
Yes.
The prevailing party.
Prevailing.
Well, who prevailed?
That's right. It's 7-7.
My point being, nobody
won. That's right.
Won.
No, 7-7. That's correct. So that motion.
Now, if someone voted wrong, then it could come back up. I didn't hear anybody say anything about voting wrong, but okay.
No, that motion fails. Moving along.
Back to see that.
Summary number 227, a resolution amending the 2016 Sewer District Number 1 Port of Iberia Fund budget in amount of $30,000 for the relocation of sewer lines budgeted in 2015, all to be funded from fund balance previous year line item.
Move
by Mr. Davis.
Second.
Second by Mr. Olivier.
All right.
Roll call. Discussion. Motion. Who didn't vote?
Me.
Sorry,
Mr.
Okay. Resolution summary number 228, a resolution amending 2016 Iberia Parish Airport Authority fund budget in amount of $100,000 to accept funding for the taxiway widening design with a 10% match from the LA Department of Transportation Development, and further amending the said budget in the amount of $16,000 for a loan payment for the Lemaire Airport Memorial Airport Hangar to be funded from fund balance previous line item.
Move.
Move by Mr. Trahan.
Second.
Second by Mr. Napier. Discussion. Roll calls. That motion carries. Summary 229, introduced by the Parish President. A resolution amending the 2016 Acadiana Fairgrounds Commission fund budget to provide for the year-end adjustments.
Move.
Move by Ms. Broussard.
Second.
Second by Mr. Landry. Discussion.
Kim.
Anybody? Discussion?
We don't have all the numbers yet.
No, this is what is the year-end. This is not to provide for the
session. Okay. I'm sorry. That's just a budget adjustment. I'm sorry.
Roll call. And motion carries. Summary 230, introduced by EDD.
I'm still thinking about that.
Oh. I'm sorry.
Oh, Mr. Napier, you got it?
I'm sorry.
Summary 230, introduced by the EDD number one, and resolution amending the 2016 Economic Development District number one fund budget in an amount of $3,697 for a change order number two of the terminal project, all to be funded from operating transfer from 2016 Port Authority fund budget.
Move.
Move by Mr. Olivier. Second by Mr. Trahan. Discussion. Roll call. That motion carries. Summary number 231, introduced by the EDD number one, a resolution granting approval to utilize approximately $200,000 in remaining funds from a utility installation associated with the Port Millennium Expansion Phase 2 project in order for the said funds to be used for road improvements on David Bayrod Road at the Port of Iberia, all as requested by the Port of Iberia Board of Commissions.
Move.
Move by Mr. Olivier.
Second.
Second by Mr. Duga. Roll call. That motion carries. Summary number 232, introduced by the parish president, resolution authorizing the removal of the fiscal agreement renewal of the fiscal agent agreement with Iberia Bank for the additional 2 years term beginning January 1st, 2017.
Move.
Move by Ms. Broussard.
Second.
Second by Mr. Paul Landry. Discussion. Roll call. That motion carries. Summary number 233, introduced by the parish president, a resolution amending the 2016 parish-wide drainage maintenance fund budget in amount of $30,000 to provide funding for the additional modeling for T-Bayou as prepared by C.H. Fenstermaker.
Move.
Move by Mr. Landry. Paul.
Second.
Second by Mr. Olivier. Any discussion? Roll call. That motion carries. Summary number 234, introduced by the parish president, a resolution amending the 2017 Recreational Playground District Fund budget in the amount of $30,000 for the maintenance cost, which was inadvertently omitted from the administration adjustments to said budget.
Move.
Move by Mr. Olivier.
Second.
Second by Mr. Paul Landry. Discussion. Roll call. That motion carries. Summary number 235, introduced by the parish president, a resolution amending the 2016 Royalty Fund budget in the amount of $91,727 to provide additional funding for the bridge repairs at Cooley Road and Dubois Canal and Norris Road and Segura Branch Canal as a result of recent bid openings.
Move.
Move, Mr. Trahan.
Second for discussion.
Yeah.
Second. Second by Mr. Paul Landry. Discussion. Discussion?
No.
Mr. Landry?
Kimberly, the money's going to come from royalty. Can you tell us approximately what we'll have left in there?
This is being funded out of the remaining bond fund. So there was approximately, and I don't know the exact number off the top of my head. It was, more than 400,000. So it's coming off of that. So it's not coming out of fund balance.
Mr. Richard?
But Paul, I want y'all to understand this because we still have other bridges that's going to go out for bid. And this is something that I think is very important. If I'm not mistaken, this work has been out in the working process for over a year. So perhaps the numbers that they estimated a year ago or a year and a half ago, whenever it was, it could potentially be a lot different than what's going to come in the first, second, third quarter of next year. So I want to make sure y'all understand what's going on here.
Okay.
All right.
I'd ask you a question, Mr. Landry? I'm assuming that when we get to the end, that we're going to have some difficult decisions to make.
Yeah, exactly. Mr. Chairman, all the bridges in my district have been repaired and paid for.
Yes. Unfortunately, you don't have a whole lot of bridges in your district.
All done.
Yeah. So you have that problem.
What about the penalty?
All right. Roll call.
Roll call.
Summary number 236, introduced by the clerk of the council, a resolution accepting the resignation of Mr. Glenn A. Bayrod as a member of the Waterworks District 4 Commissioner of Iberia Parish effected immediately.
Move.
Move by Mr. Olivier.
Second.
Second by Mr. Landry. Discussion. Roll call. That motion carries. Summary number 237, introduced by Eugene A. Olivier, Senior, District 10, a resolution of condolence to the family of Mrs. Ruth Evans Sawyer, mother of former Waterworks District 4 Commissioner member, Ms. Donna Gravois, who passed away on November 24, 2016.
Move.
Second.
Call for unanimous second.
Unanimous second.
Roll call. That motion, Mr. Davis?
No, he's
coming. Oh, Mr. Davis, I'll wait for you to vote, please, sir.
Unanimous second. Yes. Unanimous.
Thank you, sir. That motion carries.
I move, Mr. Chairman.
Stop, but easy. Ladies and gentlemen, I did not accept the adjournment. Mr. Gasha said.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, I didn't accept. Okay, Mr. Olivier.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to reconsider summary number 226, please.
Okay.
226.
Okay, so I got a motion on the floor to reconsider summary number 226. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Landry. Roll call. That motion passes for reconsideration.
I would like to make a substitute. That original motion.
That becomes the issue.
No, I'd like to make a discussion. With the vote that went.
The original, Mr. Sealy, time. Mr. Sealy, the original main motion failed. He's trying to make a substitute to the original motion that has failed on record. That is in my book that you can't do it.
You're back to starting over again on that particular matter.
Okay.
Everything has failed. Y'all have voted by majority to reconsider that particular matter. So
I got to start over for 226.
I just think the floor is open for
anything.
For anything on that particular issue.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we have a reconsideration on summary number 226, introduced by Warren P. Garcia Jr., District 5, a resolution authorizing travel expenses to attend the Police Jury Association of Louisiana 93rd Annual Conference to be held in Lake Charles, Louisiana from February 15th, 17th, 2017 at the approximate cost of $985 per attendee to defund it completely, the four members. Do I have a motion?
I move.
Move by Mr. Olivier. Do I have a second? The original main motion. Do I have a second?
I second.
Second by Ms. Broussard. Discussion.
I'm only going to
okay. Mr. Traha?
As it died, it goes back to what was in the policy. When it died the last time. My question is to you.
You said we open to anything.
Time out, Marty.
I just, hold on.
You addressing Mr. Sealy?
Yes.
Okay, Mr. Sealy. In the main motion, you said. Mr. Sealy at the floor. Yeah.
This is just my humble opinion.
Sure.
you voted by a majority to reopen that particular matter. There is no motion on the floor.
No substitute.
You basically have said, we're going to open it up to reconsider. So the members may make a motion that is germane and related to what that initial resolution was for. So you could make a motion.
That's
to,
right. You started over from the beginning.
Start over yeah. To change it, to do registration, to do $100 and y'all split it 14 ways or, you know, whatever. You're free to do that.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Sealy. Mr. Tron, you still have the floor.
Yeah, I mean, I'm asking when it died the last time on the original motion.
Okay.
Okay. Where does it go from there? Does it go back to what was
the original
policy?
Marty.
Wait,
I'm answering your question. The original motion says to defund totally. That passed by this council. There's no money.
No.
Look
it failed.
Says.
It went 7-7, right?
It failed.
It failed.
Right. It failed. So
it
goes back to
the original budget. The original money is budgeted in the budget.
That was my
I thought you were asking the original motion.
I know you can reopen it.
You could add whatever. Come up with any motions pertaining to this.
I just want to make that clarification for
you. All right. So you finished with the floor?
Yes, sir.
Ms. Broussard, you got the floor. Oh, never mind. Yeah. All right. Anybody? That's right. Anybody else has the floor? Mr. Gasha?
I want to get clarification from the clerk of the council. Ms. Bergeron, if nothing is passed tonight, that money in the budget can't be used unless passed by council?
It would only be used if it's authorized for whatever action.
So it would have to be authorized by council?
You have to authorize travel expenses.
Okay.
Thank you.
Right. Okay, so we're still in discussion on original motion.
I withdraw a second.
You withdraw your second?
Second.
So Ms. Trahan picks up the second on original motion. Any more discussion? Any clarification? Mr. Olivier?
Yes, clarification. I would like the council still to consider a fixed amount per council member to attend the conference in Lake Charles. the show of hands we saw was seven members that wished to go to the council, to the conference in Lake Charles. I think it's affordable, you know, at $600 per council member. Me for one, I don't plan on using the whole $600 because I got a sister lives in Lake Charles and I plan on visiting with her for two nights. So I may only use $430 of that money. I'm not going to use it all. It's incumbent of each of us to try to save the parish money however we can. And I feel as a council member, I have the responsibility to do that for myself. And I plan on doing that for the parish, for the taxpayer. I'm going to board with my sister and brother-in-law for a couple of nights and just spend the Friday night at the hotel because we got that banquet. I don't want to be on the road after the banquet. It just makes sense to me. Okay? And I'll pay for my own meals. I'll pay for my own travel expense to get there. I would like this council, I'm going to put a motion for to reconsider spending $600 per council member to attend the state conference in Lake Charles. Okay. With so the intentions that you don't have to spend the whole $600. If you want to be responsible, just spend what you need to spend.
Yes.
But max it out at $600.
Okay, so the substitute is to allocate $600 per council member to attend the Lake Charles conference. February 15th to 17th, 2017. I got a second by Mr. Brown. Discussion?
I got a comment.
Mr. Dugard.
Yes, my only comment right now is I know that we went through the budget and we cut a lot of stuff. One of the things we cut were NGOs that helped the local diners and SNAP programs.
That's right.
And if we got extra money, I think we need to refund those programs. And that's it.
Thank you, Mr. Dugard.
Good point, Joe. Good point, Joe.
All right. So any more discussion on the substitute motion to allocate $600 to attend the Lake Charles Conference?
Yes,
roll call. That motion fails. Back to the original motion.
All right.
Any discussion on the original motion? Original motion, Mr. Landry?
I'd like to offer a substitute motion.
Okay.
We take up.
J.E.
No, that's good.
Okay, Mr. Landry, you still have the floor.
Well, it'll be for discussion, but I offer up that we take $20,000 out of the councilman's insurance, health insurance, and we move it for travel.
That's a substitute discussion.
What?
That's not germane.
It's not germane.
All right.
All right, I got a substitute.
Come on, Mr. Napier.
I'm gonna try this again. I make a motion that we fund the $275 registration for every council member that wants to go.
Okay.
Second.
So I got a substitute motion on the floor to fund $275 registration fee for any councilman who wants to attend the Lake Charles Conference. I got a second by Mr. Broussard.
Mrs.
I apologize, Mrs. Broussard. Any discussion on that item? Mr. Gosser?
Mr. Chairman, I just can't wait till that new law becomes effective, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
Okay. Any more discussion on paying a registration fee?
$275.
Clear the board, please. Roll call.
Damn, y'all don't even want $275.
Just go home.
That motion fails. Back to the original main motion to defund the travel totally, as stated in the original resolution. Roll call. Clear the board.
There's no substitutions?
Now this is for...
Wait, it's clarification, Mr. Chairman.
Oh, yeah, it's for clarification?
So which we already voted on.
Right, the original motion.
Yeah, all right.
No money.
That motion carries.
All right.
Looking for adjournment?
Move to adjourn.
Thank you. Means adjourned.